It's been one of the toughest starts to a season we've seen in a long time for the Kalispell Warhawks. Going on the road to face both Minnesota and Penn State, I knew we'd learn a lot about this new-look football team. Against Minnesota, we saw plenty of struggles from Kalispell, and not everybody's looked prepared for their new roles on this team. Both the offense and the defense have taken major steps back this year. Despite that, Kalispell actually came into the Penn State game well-prepared. And then, Luke Irvin's injury in the third quarter changed the entire game. LaMeca Warrick helped lead a Penn State second-half comeback, while Matt Reddick, the true freshman, did not look ready for this stage. Kalispell struggled mightily in the second half, unable to move the football and turning it over multiple times. But they were still given a chance to win this game late. They just had to get in field goal range. Matt Reddick given one last chance. And this time he got the job done, and it looked like Kalispell was ready for a win. The kick is up, and it is no good! Thomas missed it! It's the first miss of his college career, and Penn State wins! At last, the Nittany Lions get some long-awaited revenge against the Warhawks, and we are 1-2 after four losses in the last 4 years combined. Kalispell closes non-conference play today, now back at home where they are one of the toughest teams to beat here at Warhawk Stadium. They've won 16 straight in this building, and quarterback Quan Tippins leads the USF Bulls into this matchup, looking to end that streak and give us our third straight loss. However, the Bulls are missing two of their best playmakers, their top running back and receiver, and the Warhawks have to be hungry to get this losing streak over with. Welcome to Week 4. It's good to be home, everybody. Kalispell in South Florida gets underway. Colt Sully will take a knee deep in the end zone, and out comes Luke Irvin, along with Austin Jenkins. Both are recovered from their injuries suffered a week ago, and they'll open with a run, Austin Jenkins to the right for about 7 yards. If there was a bright spot from last week, it was definitely the play of Austin Jenkins going for 140 yards on the ground. Now Irvin outside the pocket, he had some room to run, and instead throws wildly and inaccurate. Kalispell sure got a lot to clean up after these last two games. Third down, underneath, it's caught by Austin Jenkins, and that's a gain of 5. Kalispell saw the depth they had behind Jenkins and Irvin last week, and it wasn't very strong. Now Irvin gets outside the pocket looking to run with this one, and he'll lose the ball at his own bench after a short gain. This is a 3rd-and-1 for Kalispell. They keep it with Jenkins. He found some daylight but lost his footing, and he'll get 11, but it could have been a whole lot more. Jenkins averaging 6.2 yards a carry this season. Now up the middle, Jenkins falls ahead, and that gets 7. Kalispell marching down the field. Now they open things up. Empty backfield, 3rd-and-3. Irvin to the outside. Good hands from Jenkins, and he doesn't get it. It's 4th down, and that'll bring on Rick Thomas, trying to avenge his miss from last week. And this is a fake! It's Reddick, and they're all over it! No fooling the Bulls on this. Matt Reddick turns it over on downs. That drive had some promise at the beginning. Now it's USF taking over for the first time. Quan Tippins, the junior quarterback, on 1st down, under pressure and taken down. Michael Hurst had 2 sacks last week, and he opens the game with his 3rd of the season. Make that his 4th, actually. That leads the team. 3rd down for South Florida. Quan Tippins in the shotgun, pressured off the edge, and this pass is caught, but Johnson went to the ground. I'll never understand that rule, but it helps us there. Kalispell takes over now at their own 20, beginning their 2nd drive, and caught by Houston over the middle, escaping defenders and racing out toward the 40 for 18 yards. USF looking pretty aggressive to open. They blitz again, and this goes outside, complete to Lindsay, who gets across midfield. It's a gain of 14 for Kalispell's leading receiver. That's catch number 20. Third down now, not quite in field goal range. Pressure on Irvin. Got it away, and Lindsay does not get the first. It's fourth and one this time. There'll be no fake field goal, nor any actual field goal. It's Jenkins instead for the first down with ease. Gain of 9. This offensive line definitely looks a lot more comfortable run blocking than pass. Sweep right now, and Jenkins gets tripped up behind the line of scrimmage by Scott Gilbert. So here is another tough third down. Irvin needs 11. Blitz sent again. Irvin sends one down the middle of the field for Drake Maddox. Touchdown! And it comes on a perfect throw from Luke Irvin away from the safety and right on the money for Drake Maddox. For Irvin, it's his fifth passing touchdown of the season. He does have 3 interceptions. South Florida takes over. Here's Tippins. He can run. They ask him to do this quite a bit. He had over 800 rushing yards a season ago. Following the 14-yard pickup, Tippins now looking to throw, but he's got pressure in his face, and he is sacked. It's Jaquan Cunningham, the powerful interior rusher, and Tippins is down on the field. That was a hard hit from Cunningham, and that will bring Sean Holman in at quarterback. On a 2nd and 18, Holman is complete over the middle, finding Carter, and now a 3rd down. Empty look for South Florida. Holman against the 4-man rush, protected, takes off to the right. Cunningham meets him as well, and he won't get it. Jaquan Cunningham takes over the drive. Good opening here in the first quarter for Kalispell. It's Irvin back to the air with a quick strike. It's Maddox again, 17-yard reception. Irvin looking sharp in week 4, the 4th start of his career. Irvin finds Lindsay now. Good throw by Irvin, and Lindsay is across midfield with a gain of 16. Kalispell back in plus territory. Now they have Sean Merville in the game, and he'll take this one off tackle and send us to the 2nd quarter. 2 tight ends on the field for Kalispell. Play action for Irvin. He's taking a shot downfield on this one. It's Edwards downfield for the touchdown! And that might be the best throw we've seen from Luke Irvin. Again, he's just throwing it away from the safety, and he trusts Edwards to get that separation. It is 14-0, but there is some good news for South Florida. Look who's back. Quan Tippins breaking tackles and getting into Kalispell territory. He looks all right. 32 yards. South Florida, 1st down. Tippins again. Big block downfield on Foster. Inside the 25 and caught from behind by Brandon Williams. Kalispell had similar struggles against LaMecca Warwick last week. Here's 3rd down. Tippins downfield with this one. Good catch by Robinson with great concentration. Goal to go for the Bulls. Trying to get on the board. Williams cuts his way into the end zone. Touchdown, South Florida. Good answer after Kalispell created that momentum. It's now a 14-7 game with Kalispell taking over at their own 25. Quick screen to the right, big block for Houston from Johnny Cabral, and Houston gets 16. 2 tight ends again. Merville getting some more action now, and he'll take it up the middle for about 7. Jenkins did have 9 first quarter carries, so they're trying to balance that workload. Jenkins runs behind a good block of Drake Maddox, and he's got another 1st down. There's been a lot to like so far about this Kalispell offense today. Off play action. Irvin gets it away to the sideline. Good catch by Lindsay. He's made countless tough catches already this year. It's a 1st and 10. Handoff Jenkins, and another huge block from Cabral. He's fun to watch. Number 70, Johnny Cabral, lines up at right guard. Now to the air, protected. It's Irvin deep to the end zone with nobody covering Nick Lindsay. Touchdown! That's 3 scores to 3 receivers here in the first half, and it's maybe the best Kalispell's offense has played all season long. We've seen good glimpses from Luke Irvin, but now 3 touchdowns after 4 in his first 3 games. That's a good step forward. And USF now having to play catch-up. This is Richard Gray, the true freshman, having to step in for an injury. Third down and four for Tippins. He's got time, settles underneath, and Carter is tackled in space by Robinson. Fourth down. What is next for this Kalispell offense? It's 21-7. Again, facing the blitz. Irvin over the middle, connecting Drake Maddox into Bulls territory. Now it's 32 yards. Irvin looks very comfortable going deep today. Now Jenkins running. Oh, big hit. Austin Jenkins gets about four. Third down. Three receivers left here for Kalispell as they go empty, and the quick strike is knocked away by Jerry Green. And that will bring on Rick Thomas. Trying to avenge his miss from last week, here's a 52-yard try. On its way, and no good! Thomas missed again! This was not quite on the right hash, and now he pulls it by inches! Thomas made the first 79 kicks of his career, and now he's missed two in a row. South Florida takes over. There's 10 for Scott Carter. Bulls down two touchdowns, trying to get something before the half. Third down, a floater, and Carter has nowhere to go. That is a three and out. Two-minute drill begins for Kalispell. Irvin at the 21. Against the blitz again. Got it away and wide open. It's Lindsay up the sideline and out of bounds near the 40. Here comes some motion now from Tyrone Houston. A blitz again and pressure got through. Irvin thrown down and loses seven. How aggressive do they get on a third and 13? Down to 35 seconds. Irvin is pressured, tries to get away, and he will not, losing seven more. Fourth down. Left with 27 seconds. Quan Tippins and the USF offense takes over, and that pass is complete to Joe Sullivan, and the Bulls use their second timeout. Still a good ways to go as Tippins is protected. Johnson has the catch, and he's close. They do give him the first down. 14 seconds now, still a timeout remaining. Robinson over the middle, stretching forward across the 30. And they're playing it risky here, not using the timeout yet. Down to 3 seconds, caught by Gray, and now they'll use it and set up a field goal try. So USF not letting this one get too out of hand as it is 21-10 at the half. But for Kalispell, it has been a good bounce-back performance so far, especially offensively. We'll get right into the action here in quarter number three. USF trying to keep this one close. They're only down 11 as Gray doesn't get much. Good fill from Juno Springs. So far, Quan Tippins has had a pretty good game, had to come back from a minor injury. He throws a screen pass to Gray on third down, and he will get a lot of the yardage necessary, but not all of it. Luke Irvin had 3 first half passing touchdowns, and he'll start this half with a draw to Jenkins, and this gets Kalispell about 9. It's been a really good blend today, a rush and pass. Handoff Jenkins, carry number 16 with another great block from Johnny Cabral. I love watching that. Kalispell up to their own 26 now. Irvin gets this one away just in time. This is Houston finding daylight. And now in the clear, racing down the middle of the field. Touchdown, Tyrone Houston. 74-yard screen pass. Watch the junior from Cape Coral, Florida, run away from everybody. He grew up just 2 hours south of Tampa. And nobody in Florida recruited him. Are you kidding me? It is a 28-10 game. Can USF get the answer to close the gap? They give Tippins some time on this one, and he rewards that effort with a magnificent throw. Somehow that got past Brandon Williams. Now in Kalispell territory. Screen pass for Andre Johnson. Juno Springs says no. Third down now for South Florida. Four-man rush. Tippins floating again. Joseph there with 3, maybe 4 defenders in his path. And now they'll kick. This to make it a 2-score game again. A 50-yard try. And this kick is short and wide to the right. The Warhawks take over up by 18. Here's some motion now. Tyrone Houston gets the sweep. He's breaking free again. He can fly. Houston to the 20. They will not catch him. Touchdown. Two touchdowns on his last two touches. Kalispell extends their lead. There's a lot of new on this team this year, but there's a lot of dynamic players out there for Kalispell. Tyrone Houston, one of them, as Foster gets his hands on that throw. It's a 3rd and 10 for South Florida. Screen for Gray. Looks like it's going to work. He's got the first and is out of bounds at the Kalispell 45. Two deep safeties for Kalispell. Now Tippins on first down, finding Williams on the angle route. And that'll take USF inside the Kalispell 30. Still in hurry-up mode. Tippins against the blitz. Angle route again. Now they beat Jordan in coverage. And Williams stretches ahead, almost scoring again. Goal to go. Split backs. Tippins. Hit. Stays on his feet. And brought down by Tommy Jordan. A red zone stand here would be perfect. Second down, Tippins flips to Gray. Robinson with the tackle, and it brings up a 3rd and goal from the 2. Tippins calling his own number, a big stiff arm on Elliott Red, and that'll bring him to the end zone. Touchdown, Bulls. Elliott Red has not looked ready to play linebacker this year. Braylon Kendrick has been a lot more reliable. It's now a 35-17 game, and on the return, watch out, Colt Sully with his best so far this year across the 40. Kalispell up 35-17, and they will run it left side. Oh, what a hit on Austin Jenkins. It's still a first down. Handoff now to the right. Jenkins got some room again, following Houston and weaving his way inside the 30, now getting 19 more. Great all-around offensive game for Kalispell. More play action. They've done well with this. Irvin buys time and works to the outside, finding Lindsay. And that will take him to the century mark receiving. Another busy afternoon for Nick Lindsay. Now 1st and 10. Irvin to the end zone. Touchdown. Another Tyrone Houston score on 3 straight possessions. You had your chance to recruit him, South Florida. He was just a couple hours away. Instead, he's come to Kalispell, and today is his signature performance. Here's a deep shot from Tippins, and incomplete. 2 defenders collided. 38 seconds to go here in the quarter. Tippins to the right on 2nd down, and completes to Carter for a gain of 14. Elliott Red in the game right now at safety as Tippins spreads out the defense. He'll throw short. Schuler catches, breaks a tackle, and he's inside the Warhawk 30. Tippins has fought hard all game, not letting this offense just roll over at all. Complete again to Andrew Robinson. I do have some concerns with some of the pass yardage allowed from Kalispell. I'd like to see them contest more of these passes. Wow. That was one incredible throw to Devron Joseph. And now goal to go USF. Tippins keeping again and falling ahead into the end zone. Again, that helps close the gap a little bit. A comeback still would be very difficult, but USF down now by 18. Kalispell taking over. Irvin rolls away from pressure and dumps this one off to Jim Jackson, who's going to get some snaps now. 3 of 7 on 3rd down. Here's Irvin needing 6 to the middle now, and knocked away again by Jerry Green. If USF scores here, it's only a 2-score game. 3rd and 7 for Quan Tippins. Kalispell generates some pressure. Tippins all the way across the field. Good effort from Henry, and they're going to have to go for it here, needing 4. And there is no safety deep. Big blitz sent. Tippins complete, but not close to the first. Turnover on downs. Now Kalispell can work on running out this clock. Jackson still in. Breaking this one to the outside here. Showing some burst and some power at the end. The power is Jackson's calling card. I wanted to see more yards after contact. He didn't impress us much in the offseason practice, but another good run here gets 6 yards. Third down and three. He'll keep it right in the hands of number 29, and again he falls ahead, and he gets the job done. That clock is moving. Third and nine now for Kalispell. Irvin to the air, wants another touchdown, but knocked away by DJ Ferguson, intended for Colt Sully. And of course, that brings out Rick Thomas again. Now a shorter attempt, and this kick is through the uprights. Rick Thomas makes it. 45-24 now. It does not appear that South Florida is done, however. We have Quan Tippins under pressure off his back foot for Joseph. What a pass. 20 yards this time. Lee in motion on first down. Tippins running again, broke a tackle, and now a clear path to the end zone. He scores again. I've been really impressed today by Quan Tippins. He looks like a player who could have a professional future. 14-point game. Now a big onside try, picked up by Nick Lindsay, the sure-handed wide receiver who has broken out here in non-conference play. Now can Kalispell end this? Jackson carrying, and he's close, but does not convert. Jackson's gotten this entire quarter to himself in the backfield, and that's a conversion on third down and inches. 2 minutes left to play. South Florida using their timeouts. Jackson with room to run, and again falling forward. If he keeps doing this, he'll earn more playing time. This could be it right here. Third and two. Jackson one more time. First down, Kalispell. That was a wonderful quarter for Jim Jackson, and it helps seal a Kalispell win. They defeat South Florida. Luke Irvin throws 5 touchdowns in the process, and they get their second win on the year, finishing up non-conference play with a 500 record. 45-31 is your final, and you had to be impressed by Luke Irvin today. That was an outstanding performance with 2 really impressive throws. That one, my favorite all year. But then it was the Tyrone Houston show, and he made his case to get the ball a whole lot more. On 2 plays in a row, he combined for over 130 yards. But a great all-around game. Austin Jenkins, 98 on the ground. Jackson had 64. I just didn't want to get Jenkins unnecessary hits in the fourth quarter. It was also a great chance to see Jackson. Johnny Cabral also is a dominant run blocker. I knew he would be after a couple years. He's special. So non-conference play is over, and that means Pac-12 play is set to begin. Kalispell up to number 10 in the standings. And our next game will be against Colorado, a team that is winless, but remember, they were bad a year ago, and they still gave us one of our most challenging games. The recruiting special will be upcoming as well. I'm not sure if it's going to be before or after this game, but it is in the works. But we'll try to get back above 500 against the winless Buffaloes, and here's a look at their roster. They do have some talent at wide receiver, and the pass game has given us some issues this year. We didn't defend it well today, giving up a lot of yards to Quan Tippins. So I'm still hoping we can see some big improvements in that department, especially when we get into some of our more challenging conference games. Luke Irvin now has 9 passing touchdowns and 3 rushing in 4 games. Austin Jenkins is doing well, and we're seeing some players break out in the passing game. Tyrone Houston has now either tied or broken all of his career highs this year, and I expect him to have a really big season going forward. By the way, I looked back to find out his recruiting, and here's a look. He was kind of a last-minute recruit for us after year 7, and the only competition was Virginia Tech, and thankfully he chose us. What will Tyrone Houston do next? We'll find out shortly. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed this episode. You probably did a lot more than the last two. Please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, leave your feedback below. What did you think about today's game? I'll see you all next time. Have a great day.